Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor sidebar from Syncfusion. Almost every application needs a navigation system, make moving through the app easy. For some apps, multi-level menus may be required to organize navigation for end users. Though Blazor has default navigation, you can replace it with our Blazor sidebar component that includes a rich set of features and allows you to place primary and secondary content alongside the main app content. In this video, I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor sidebar to an app, how to close and open the sidebar manually, and how to change the sidebar position. Finally, I will show how to integrate the ListView component into the Blazor sidebar. To explore other features available in Syncfusion Blazor sidebar, refer to the link in the card above. Now, let's add the Syncfusion Blazor sidebar to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. In this tutorial, I am going to create a new Blazor app. But before I create a Blazor application, I will make sure the latest version of the .NET Core SDK is installed in my machine. I should also have Visual Studio Code, Visual Studio 2019, or Visual Studio 2022 installed. With that confirmed, we can start building the app. Let me open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Blazor Sidebar Example and click Next. After that, I click the Create button with the default target framework selected to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly apps and how to add Syncfusion components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Now, let's add the Blazor sidebar component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Navigation's NuGet package into my application. So, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Syncfusion Blazor Navigations in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation is complete, I navigate to the imports.razor file. Here, I will add the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations namespace to start using the Blazor sidebar in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method @SyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Here, I have set the ignore script isolation option as true, as I am going to load the script externally. I should also register a valid license key in my application. So, let me register a trial license key using the method registerLicense. I then need to define the CSS for the Blazor sidebar. I navigate to the index.html file to reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Then, I will add the Syncfusion Blazor script reference here, as I have enabled the ignore script isolation property for better loading performance of the application. Now everything is configured, so let me add the Blazor sidebar component. First, I need to open the index.razor component, where I will remove the default code by including a few division and span elements. For these division elements, I am going to set titles, so let me define two variables, header text and main content, with the appropriate values. Now, I will assign these variables to this span and division elements. Within this division element, I will add the sidebar component with the property width. Then, I will define a child content tag and add a content sidebar inside the division element. For better alignment, I have defined some CSS styles for these division elements under this style section. Along with this, I will remove the default Blazor navigation layout from the main layout.razor file to get a clear view of how our sidebar is placed and used for easy navigation between different pages. Now, I will run this example. Here, you can see the output page is a simple web page layout displayed with header, main content, and sidebar. Notice that the Blazor default navigation layout is replaced with the defined layout design. By default, the sidebar component is positioned at the left side of the page. Suppose I want to place the sidebar at the right side of the main content, then I would need to define the property position and set its value as right. See the output page now, the sidebar is placed at the right side of the main content. Next, I am going to explain how to add a button control that we will use for opening and closing the sidebar. First, I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Buttons. Then, I add the Blazor Button component with the property CSS class to set a custom style for the button. I am going to set a menu icon for the button component, so let me add the icon CSS property and set appropriate class names to it. I am planning to position the sidebar component at the left, so let me set the position property value to left. Along with this, I have defined few CSS styles within this style section. Look at the output page now, the menu button is added to the left corner of the page. Next, I will demonstrate how to open and hide the sidebar component with the button we just added. I add the event on click with an appropriate event handler for the button component. Then, I define a Boolean variable, toggle sidebar, and assign it to bind as open property to show and hide the sidebar on clicking the button. Within this menu button click method, I set the toggle sidebar variable as not toggle sidebar, which means the toggle sidebar value will be true. Because, by default, a false value will be set to the Boolean variable if a value is not assigned to it. Look at the output page now. If I click the menu button, the sidebar component is closed. To show it again, I click the menu button. Next, I will show you how to integrate another component, the list view, into the sidebar. To work with the list view component, first, I need to import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor lists and include the Blazor list view code inside the child content tag. Here, I am planning to display three items in the list view, so let me define a model class, ListViewDataModel, with two fields, text and ID. Then, I will create a ListViewData of type ListViewDataModel and assign values to it. Next, I need to assign this list to the DataSource property of the ListView component. The appropriate fields should be mapped for this data source, so let me define the ListView field settings tag with TValue property and map the fields text to the text property and the ID to the ID property. Along with this, I will change the main content value with an appropriate content value. I am also planning to show content near the button, so I will add a span element with the content language. Look at the output page now, the sidebar component is rendered with the options JavaScript, React, and Vue. Notice here, the main content is hidden partially when the sidebar is shown. To make the sidebar more responsive, let me define the property media query and set the minimum width as 600. Here, you can see the sidebar component is now acting more responsive and fully shows the main content. Suppose I want to change the main content while choosing the options, then I would use the clicked event of the list view component. To add events to the list view component, first, I need to define the list view events tag with the TValue property inside the Blazor list view code. Then, I add the clicked event with the appropriate event handler. Here, I am planning to pass a description of the language, so let me add one more field, description, within this list view data model class and assign appropriate values to it. Then, I define the onSelect event handler and set the main content value as itemData.description, as I am going to show a language description while the items are selected. See the output page now, when I choose an item from the list view, the respective language description is shown. Next, I will explain how to display list view items partially when the sidebar is collapsed. First, I will define the enable doc property and set its value as true. Then, I will set doc size with an appropriate value to specify the size of the sidebar in the doc state. Look at the output page now. While collapsing the sidebar, the list view items are only partially shown. Notice that, by default, the sidebar expanding type is auto. The Syncfusion Blazor Sidebar component supports other expanding options like over, push, and slide. Now, I am going to expand the sidebar using the over option, so let me define the property type and set its value as over. Now, you can see the sidebar floats over the main content. Similarly, you can set the Blazor sidebar expanding type as push and slide. Let's recap what we have covered in this video. We saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor sidebar component to it. Also, we discussed how to change the sidebar position and its expanding types. We also saw how to make sidebar component more responsive and how to set dock state in sidebar. Finally, we saw how to open and close the sidebar component manually, as well as how to integrate ListView component into the sidebar component. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.